What's it go? How's it going, guys? Kawasaki here, and today I'm going to be giving a bit of a breakdown and my predictions and thoughts going into Stardom Sunshine. So, this pay-per-view is actually happening tomorrow night, or in Japan's time, on Sunday, June 26th. It will be June 25th here in the States. We have quite the card, I do gotta say. I know the last half of the card gonna be nuts. So if you like what you're watching, click on the like button and subscribe if you're new. There's a link to the Discord down below if you want to do a watch along. I will be watching this tomorrow night. So without any further ado, let's get this started. So to kick things off, we have a 6-woman tag match between Saeeda, Momokogo, and Hanan taking on Waka Tsukiyama, Yuna Mizumori, and Aya Sakura. Then we have your passion injection match between Hanako and Nanae Takahashi. Then we have Shuri taking on Xena. And a 6-woman tag match between Meltier and Kairi taking on Suzu Suzuki, Micah, and Maesara. Your one of two title matches are the Goddess of Stardom Championships as Mariah and Amisurei are going up against Mina Shirakawa and Mariah May. And your co-main event for the Artist of Stardom Championships in a 6-woman cage match will be Mai Sakurai, Julia, and Tekla taking on Hazuki, Mai Iwatani, and Koguma. And in your main event, we have Queen's Quest, Owero Tai, in a steel cage, and the loser must leave their faction. A lot of stakes are on the line for that one. But let's get down to the first match between Hanan, Saeeda, Momokogo, Waka, Yunamon, and Aya Sakura. So on one team we have the Stars. Another team we have the mix of Cosmic Angels, Club Venus, and no faction. Aya Sakura is still the rookie going into this. And Waka and Yuna Mizumori are, I guess, the quote-unquote newbies. But on the other side, we have Saeeda, Momokogo, Hanan. I know Waka's been on a hot streak, I believe. I need to catch up on some of these shows. And Yuna Mizumori was a part of the Neo Stardom Army, but she left and joined the Cosmic Angels. Aya Sakura still has yet to decide on a faction to join. But I know that... I know Saeeda, I believe she won a match recently. I know Momo had her New Japan match where she was highly praised. And Hanan is definitely going through quite the... not necessarily like a brand or a gimmick change, but like she's changing up her gimmick quite a bit. Gonna be a fun opener. But I'm gonna put my money on the Stars. Stardom. And now, we got your passion injection match. Inject the passion into my veins. Hanako, Nanae Takahashi. I mean, I don't know what the deal is with Nanae Takahashi trying to inject passion into everybody. But she's done it to Yuna Mizumori. She's done it to Waka. She's done it to, I believe, Mai Sakurai. And next, after Hanako, will be Starlight Kid, which will be next week on Flashing Champions, during that pay-per-view. So, I mean, she'll definitely inject some passion into Hanako. But what else could you really expect that Yuna Mizumori is going to pick up the win on this one? So, pick Nanae Takahashi. Then, we have Shuri and Xena. And I'm still gonna be 100% honest. I haven't watched Xena's work as of recent, but I'm still gonna bet my money on Shuri. So, yeah. Now this match: Kairi Tompoi, Micah Suzu May. A very, very bright future for Suzu. Micah really
I feel she's going to be on the way to going up the card, and May Sarah recently joining in.
But still quite promising. Sorry, she didn't show up back then as May Hoshizuki, so we can't really count her out as of yet. But I feel like the biggest challenge is going to be Tom Poi Kairi. Kairi kind of got thrown into this with the Cosmic Angels because when Tom won the belt, Kairi, Poi, Sari, and El restart won the artist belts. So Kairi's kind of here just to be here. But it'll be a very interesting matchup with Kairi and Suzu. They went up against each other for the artist belts when it was Prominence and Restart. But also Kairi, Micah. Like, that's the possibilities. There's a lot of stuff that could be put on this card. Or at least, like, in this match, I should say. But if I want to look at it at a bigger picture, Micah's looking really strong right now, as well as May and Suzu. May only lost her, like, the high-speed match, but that was pretty much it when it comes to, like, singles. I think tag, she's still undefeated. I might be wrong. And Suzu booked really strong. Only really lost to Julia, I think, this year in the singles. Then you have Poi coming off of an artist title reign. Same with Kairi, but Kairi is Kairi. And Tom two belts. It's really hard to pick a winner on this. And there's so much story going into both sides. So for this one, I do have to say this could potentially go to a time limit draw, or Natsupoi eats the pin, which is very unfortunate. But in this case, I'm leaning more towards a time limit draw on this one. Now, Goddess Stardom title belts on the line: Mirai, Ami Sarai, Mina Shirakawa, Mirai Mei. With Mina, she has called out Mirai. Tom has also called out Mirai since Mirai is challenging for the Wonder Belt next week. Called her out saying that she just, like, she has the belt just to have a belt. She's also won back-to-back Cinderella, and she's had absolutely nothing going for her. Mirai is still trying to deny that claim, and again, Mina's also saying that you don't really have, like, the heart, the passion, the drive to be a champion. You just want a champion just to have under your resume, which is some harsh reality. I mean, at least Ami's trying, okay? You gotta give her that. But Mirai, she's being selfish. But then, if you look at Amina's side, the last time she's challenged for the belt was with Unagi, has failed each and every time. So I wonder how this is gonna turn out. It's hard to say. I could either see time limit draw or Mariah May eats the pin. Because you have to make Mariah look strong going into the her title match against Tom. She's probably gonna lose that match, but again, time limit draw or Mariah May eats the pin. Or third time's the charm, perhaps? But I'm leaning more towards the belts not dropping. Now we get to the fun stuff right here. Cage match. Julia, Tekla, Mai Sakura, I've never been in a cage match. And the last time they had a cage match, it was Mayu, Koguma, Hazuki that defeated Queen's Quest's Saya, Utami, and Izumi. I mean, you had Hazuki jump off the cage. You had Koguma jump off the cage. You had Mayu wanting to get the hell out of there. It was actually funny, too, because Hazuki Koguma actually proposed a cage match, and Donald D'Amato said, yeah, sure, why not? And Mayu definitely was not having it. I wonder what spots are going to do for this one. Are they going to repeat the same spots they did last year? Or will it be something new? Will Mayu jump off the cage? Will Tekla jump off the cage? Will there be a move off the top of the cage? The world may never know until tomorrow night. I could see Stars win this, but I could also see Donald DeMondo, like, retain. This one's a 50-50, if I'm going to be 100% honest. Flip a coin. Donald DeMondo retains. But again, this one's very 50-50. I wouldn't complain if either party won or lost. Then we get to the main event. Queen's Quest, Auto Tie. They're running it back, this time in a cage, and with higher stakes. If they're the last person in the cage must leave their respective faction. So you have Hina, Lady C, Miyu Amasaki, Izumi, Utami, and Saya taking on Saki, Ruwaka, Rina, Momo, Tora, Starlight Kid. They've had quite the rivalry the past few years. And I know, I believe it was 2 years ago, they kind of did the same thing, but it was an elimination. It was Captain Falls, loser must join the other person's faction. But that time, it was Momo that betrayed Queen's Quest to join Oedo Tai. And currently, Saya and Utami have been having they've been having their differences. So I wonder whether this is going to escalate. Is Saya going to leave Queen's Quest? Is Utami going to leave Queen's Quest? Because in my personal honest opinion, Oedo Tai doesn't look like they're going to lose. Like, they're not going to lose anybody. Because you have High Speed Champion, Future Stardom Champion. Ruwaka was a great Future Stardom Champion. Then Tora coming back, at least for, like, some that's in her playing field. And on Queen's Quest, you have Saya and Utami want to rip each other's throats out. You have Izumi saying, like, I ain't trying to deal with this shit anymore. Like, y'all need to chill the fuck out. Then you have Miyu, which needs a reality check. Lady C as well. Hasn't this, like, Miyu, Hina, Miyu, Lady C, and Hina don't really have the best track record compared to the three. But it could be same otherwise towards Wado Tai. I mean, you have Saki winning the high speed belt. You have Rina winning the future belt as of recent. And Ruwaka kind of there. But other than any outside title matches, those three are just like kind of there. Again, they're kind of in the same boots, like kind of same shoes as C, Miyu, and Hina. And they have Starlight Kid, Momo, Tora carrying. But then you have also like the slim percentage. Saki's there. Saki got it in the bag. Again, this is really tough. Because you could have Utami betray Saya, leave the cage, and force Saya out. You could have Utami just forcing Saya to leaving. Utami gets booted. And you're out of the leader. Or if you really want to throw a curveball, Momo goes back to Queen's Quest. Or Momo, like, leaves Oedo Tai. Starlight Kid leaves Oedo Tai to do something new. Or you have Izumi leaving Queen's Quest to do something new. And then you could have the unfortunate circumstances of Hina, Miyu, Lady C, Ruwaka, and Rina leaving. But if I had to make picks, I'm going to go towards Oedo Tai winning, and Saya gets booted. Because there's been quite a change of character with Saya recently. But that's just my observation. But that is the card for Stardom Sunshine. It is happening tomorrow night, I think at 9, 10 o'clock at night. I'm going to be so asleep. But I will be watching this live. If y'all want to watch, link to my Discord is in the description down below. Otherwise, I'll be putting up a link on social media. Click on that bell icon. It'll notify you when I'm live and watching. So, thank y'all for watching, and I will catch you on my next stream. Peace.